Let me just read this out. Gio Osas is sending. He's saying, as we speak, a strike is looming. One of the IOCs as labor contracts are ending, and the IOC is converting, if not all, the labor staff to casual in the name of cost savings. And he says that will take out pension, HMOs, and labor laws. Would that IOC?
That IOC obviously will run foul of the law. You couldn't hire people and push them over the fence because you're trying to save money. The duties of an employer and an employee are very clear. You can hire, you can fire. There are terms under which you hire, there are terms under which you fire. As long as you follow the process, you can meet your objective, but you can't keep somebody hanging in the balance or review his terms while he's still answering casual staffing. So we're going to look at each of those. Some have come to us. We've taken up some of those. Some have been amended. We've been able to understand the explanation in some and try to explain it to the union. But we're doing a holistic survey right now of the oil industry to see what exactly is happening. Is this really a rampant thing, like some of the union members say? The ones that have been brought to my attention I've looked at. Some had credibility, some didn't. But, you know, at the end of the day, I think the labor laws of the country are very, very clear on this issue, and we just need to enforce those.
Okay. I want to quickly take you to the PID, which has been one big bone down our necks. But it would seem that it's made some progress. I think you submitted another draft to the National Assembly. Interestingly, the Senate, you didn't submit another draft?
No.
Well, the Senate came up with his own draft, if you didn't. Well, they had their own, and they broke it down. They had the PIGB, they had I think for community relations as well. They had a number, I think about three or four bills, which they broke it down into to ensure that it did not suffer the hitches it suffered the last time. The House of Representatives had a different approach, but interestingly, they have come to the same table with the Senate now, and they're looking at passing the PIGB. I think it's been passed now.
It's been passed.
What progress has it made with the executive? Has it been signed?
No, it hasn't been submitted to us yet. It's still going through the final. It's been passed, but then they need to formally lay it before the president. My understanding is that, at least as of the last 3 weeks, they haven't done that.
Have you been able to see a draft copy of what has been passed?
Yes, we worked with them collaboratively. If you watched my session in the Senate during the clearing of ministers, I was asked a question then, what was my direction in terms of PIB, what would I support? And at that point, I did make that point that as long as you continue to try to do PIB as a one single entity document, that's really where this whole thing started. I said, you need to split it. I think at that time I suggested three. They've come up with four nicely. And that has helped. So one of the things we've done is also sink into the consulting teams that they've worked with, the ministry, the parastatals, working collaboratively with them so that nothing jumps out as a complete surprise. There are areas where we disagree, but a lot of the areas I think we've agreed. And so we've worked with them. I think they've done a fantastic job of it. We'll see what eventually is a clean copy that gets us. I have seen some of the rough copies because we've been involved in the process, and I think, in my view, I think they're on the right track.
Mm. Just wondering as well, you hosted recently, Nigeria hosted the NIPS here in Nigeria. You said you no longer attend the OTCs. That was especially as minister, and anyone who wanted to go should be going on their own, should fund their trips. What, hosting a particular summit here, what benefits would you say accrue to us immediately?
Well, first of all is attention. And the reason I took that decision was that I'd been in the oil industry for close to 30 years. I think I probably attended about four or five OTCs working in the industry, and I've attended one as minister. And it was clear to me that what you found every year when you went to Houston was that 90% of those who went to OTCs never even showed up at the trade fair sites or any of the conferences. People went on holidays. And in most cases, government paid for these holidays. And so my attitude, and in any case, what investments came from there? Because most times you go to OTC, they're expecting you to bring your marginal fields, be drowned to them to show them there. They're expecting you to come and sell the country. Nothing goes with you. The same number of multinational oil companies that have been here are the same ones that have been here. There's been any progress even on domestic producer capability growth. So my attitude was that the only way you can force these people into this environment is to bring them here. And that's not to say people shouldn't go for OTC, because I was misunderstood saying I banned OTC. I didn't ban OTC. I simply banned government sponsorship under me of OTC attendance. If anybody wants to take leave and go and attend OTC, or if for whatever reason we find in a particular year there is some level of exhibition on new technologies that they're doing, and we need to send some of our technical people, it will be a bit more synthesized attendance. So first thing was notice. Second was that you had exhibitions for the first time that are happening here from countries outside Nigeria that were relevant to our technology growth. Third was that we were able to exhibit some of the technology improvements that Nigerians have in fact been able to develop. Nigerians have been in this field for over 50 years. And quite frankly, if you look at all the operating fields in Nigeria, most of them are run by Nigerians. You know, so there are lots of technologies that are hidden, they're not trademarked, not patented, that are ongoing. The oil companies are obviously benefiting from that because of the fact these are their staff. But as smaller companies are beginning to open up shops, some of the least cost producers we have today are Nigerian companies.